Classic car collecting was never your average hobby in the USSR. In Soviet times, a personal car was a luxury rather than an everyday mode of transport. Preserving old-timers was not the done thing, except for Dmitry Lomakov, whose love of vintage vehicles runs in his blood.
My father happened to be part of a team who in 1959 restored a Rolls-Royce that belonged to Vladimir Lenin, and before him to the Russian royal family. That's how his passion for old cars started. He began collecting them. And then I got the idea to turn it all into a museum.
Russia's first private museum of retro cars. Over 40 years, the Lomakov family collected more than 250 vintage cars and motorcycles. And it took Dmitry more than 10 years to set up the museum. Located in Moscow's southeast, it's now among the most visited in the capital. For a modest price of 200 rubles, motoring fans can see some truly unique gems, from German cars captured during World War II to Soviet classics. And here's Dmitry's pride and joy.
It's a ZIS-110 limousine. These cars were for the top party elite only. And this one was made in 1949 on Stalin's order, as his gift to the Patriarch of Russia, Alexei I, for the church's contribution to the war effort. It's green because in Orthodoxy, this color symbolizes the victory of good over evil. And as Stalin originally studied to be a priest, he sure knew it.
And Dmitry isn't the only one who's put his hobby on display for everyone to see.
Private museums are nothing new in Russia. Before the revolution, they flourished, with Moscow's perhaps most outstanding example being the Tretyakov Art Gallery, that grew out of a private initiative of merchant Pavel Tretyakov. In the USSR, the tradition was lost. The words Soviet and private didn't marry well. Now, though, things are changing.
There are no official statistics, but some figures suggest Moscow alone has more than 100 private museums. But some of them are a more exclusive affair than others, like this contemporary art gallery. Opened in 2007, it houses a collection of works by Soviet and modern Russian artists. But getting to see it is a bit of a challenge. The entry fee is a whopping 6,000 rubles. And even if you are ready to flash the cash, you can't just turn up. Advanced booking is required. The museum's founder and owner, a businessman turned art collector, explains.
It started 17 years ago when I bought a painting to cover up a hole in the wall. Then I got hooked. I decided to open a gallery because in 100 years, Russia hadn't had a private museum of modern art. But to stay successful, you've got to keep surprising the public all the time. And I eventually tired of it, so I turned the museum into a sort of closed club and went back to collecting.
But no matter how open or exclusive they may be, both venues tell the stories of how one man's passion can grow into something bigger, as the tradition of Russia's private museums returns. Svetlana Kurakina, Primetime Russia, RT.